Hey, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Patrick, your favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right. You know, I've just been worshiping the Lord, and the Lord has been showing me so many things, brothers and sisters. I want to share with you, but let's just worship Him some more. I can't help it. Let's worship Him. Hallelujah, Lord God. We worship You. Hallelujah. Blessed be His holy name. Daniel went to Babylon. Israel into the Gentile diaspora. After Daniel died, there arose Esther, who was a foreign bride. She was a foreign bride, married to the king of kings, the king of kings on earth at that time, the king of Persia, the Medes and the Persians, who took over for Nebuchadnezzar from the time of Daniel. Now this foreign bride was a bridge to Nehemiah. This foreign bride impacted. You know, she was adopted into that family, and so her husband's son became the king. And then that son had a cupbearer who was a leader amongst the Israelites, amongst the Jews, as it's called at that, by that time. Daniel was a leader, as a matter of fact, of the bloodline of the kings of Judah. He was of the royal lineage of King David. Went into the diaspora, held a leadership position in the Gentile world. After his death, there arose this foreign bride, Esther. She's an Israelite, but she's also a foreign bride to the kingdom, representing the bride. She's married to the king. She's such an impact in that kingdom, and a bridge, and many things the Lord is showing me. She's a bridge to Nehemiah, the cupbearer of her stepson, who went back for the restoration and rebuilding up of Jerusalem and the temple. Second part, Esther also interceded to the king on behalf of Israel. The life and death of Israel was dependent on Esther. I'm giving you three different parables that the Lord gave me. The life of Israel was dependent on Esther, the foreign bride, representative of the Gentile church. She interceded to the King of Kings on behalf of the people of Israel. Same role that we, the church, have had for the last 2,000 years. But after Esther was gone, and Esther had departed out of this world, then it was the time and the days when the King of Kings, his son of the King of Kings, he had a cupbearer. And that cupbearer, his servant, went back to restore the nation of Israel and rebuild the walls in troubled times. And he succeeded in that. Third piece of this parable from the Lord, Joseph was sold for 30 pieces of silver, was denied by his brethren and sold into slavery, carried off into Egypt. He was placed in the pit. But after a season, he was resurrected and revived and exalted to the right hand of Pharaoh, that no one in all of Egypt would lift a foot save by the command of that viceroy of Egypt, Joseph, son of Israel. Joseph, Yosef ben Israel. Now Joseph was not recognized by his brother, the Israelites. When they came down to Egypt to buy grain, they did not recognize him. But the second time they went down, the second time they met him, they recognized him. The first time they went, they thought he was, hey, this guy's a Gentile viceroy, assistant to the Pharaoh, the father of Egypt, Pharaoh. At his right hand seated Joseph. He appeared as a Gentile to the children of Israel. But the second time they went down, he revealed himself. The second time that he came, he revealed himself and said, I am Joseph, your brother. Now this parable, and this parable from the Lord continues. And so Joseph was in charge. They stored up provisions for 7 years. And those provisions were for Israel. The father of Egypt, the Pharaoh, gave his viceroy, the one seated in his right hand, Joseph, he gave him authority to bring the children of Israel there and put them in the land of Goshen to protect them and save them during this famine. But in the beginning of the famine, they were in their land, brothers and sisters. This parable continues. And even more the Lord's given me now. I hope I can remember all the parts by the grace of God. In the beginning, they were in their land, in Egypt, or in Israel, in the land of Canaan. They were there, sojourning when the 7 years of famine began. And after coming down for a few seasons to get provision from Joseph, finally, sometime, like in the middle of that 7 years of famine, they were moved to the land of Goshen. They were moved to a land of protection, protected by Joseph, the one that was sold into slavery and was down in the pit for a season, but then was exalted, resurrected from a prison life, from being under in the prison, which the prison was actually literally underground there in Egypt, exalted to the right hand of the father of Egypt, to the Pharaoh. More. So continue this parable from the Lord. Israel, before he died, he blessed the two sons of Joseph, Ephraim and Manasseh. And he gave Joseph, before he died, Israel gave Joseph the well that he had got there. The well that he had got there at, they believe it's Shechem. And so he gave that to Joseph. Well, we see Yeshua, Jesus, the Messiah, John chapter 4, sitting at a well, the very well. Israel gave that well to Joseph, who was seated in as a Gentile ruler at the right hand of the father of Egypt. He gave that wellspring of living water. Then we see the Messiah, not the type and shadow, but the very thing that we seek after, came suddenly to that well, to these Gentile people, the Samaritans, these mixed blood Samaritan people, and said, you drink from this well and you will thirst again. But the well I give you, the water I give you, is such a kind that if you drink it, you'll never thirst again. It's a wellspring of everlasting life. That exact same well is where the Samaritan woman drew the water. This Gentile water drew the water from Yeshua, who was an Israelite. She says, what are you doing? You're an Israelite asking me for water. You're a Jew. I'm a Samaritan. You're asking me for water. See, here is Jesus as the Jewish rabbi offering the living water to this Gentile woman from the well that Israel, Jesus was an Israelite, a son of Jacob. That well he had given to Joseph, who gave provision to Israel as a Gentile ruler. Brothers and sisters, now I've just begun to lay out this outline of this parable. God bless you all. May the grace of God be with you always. May His light shine upon you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I speak the grace of God to be upon you. I speak the wisdom of God to be upon you. Hallelujah. 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 Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. And you dwell, and you will shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. God bless.